spiritual children. And so the question that we ask ourselves, even in our clothing, is simply this, is as a spiritual father, where are we? Because remember, if you don't beget anyone, that's a contradiction. You know, remember the question we always ask, why did God save us? God did not save us just to get to heaven. God saved us so that we can go out and be that third party that witnesses to other people that will bring them in to the kingdom. Amen. And if you're the one that God uses to bring them into the kingdom, then that's your beget.
Yeah.
You have a responsibility to nurture and to make and to mold that person. Amen. As long as they're willing to what? To be obedient to God's word. Amen. And even when they become disobedient, you still say, I'm going to come to you. I can come, it can be nice, or it can be what? It can be naughty. However you want it, I'm going to come. Because we have a responsibility. Because if they are truly a child of God, the end result will be what? Repentance. If they're a real child of God, they will repent. Because the Holy Spirit will not allow them not to repent. And that means what? You might have to go through Matthew 18 in order to what? To get the rod out. You go to them by yourself, you bring another person, they still don't listen. You bring it to the church, they still don't listen. You put them out of the church. And then what? They will repent then if they're true children, and then you've gained your brother.
Yeah.
So we have a choice today. Either we can continue to have a church of immature people, or we can begin to take on the roles that God has called us to have, such as spiritual fathers and spiritual mothers. And guess what? It's going to be hard. It's not going to be fun all the time, but the joy and the satisfaction that God gives in the midst of you, what, making more disciples. How do you think Paul felt about Timothy when he said, I'm going to send Timothy? He probably had a big old smile on his face, but he was also sad, too, because he had to send what? His beloved. But he was excited that he had someone that he could trust with the gospel to represent him. Let's be our goal. As we go. I was truly convicted as I was going through this. I'm like, oh, Lord, where are my children? You know, who can I send? I had to start asking myself, if I couldn't go, who would I send? You see? And that's what we should be asking ourselves, because what it does, it helps us identify where we're at.
Yeah.
Have we committed child abuse, you know, spiritually? Have we begotten and just left them? Those are the things that we have to be confronted with as far as the Spirit is concerned. Because it's not like God can't forgive us, but our prayer is that God will what? He will give us a renewal of heart, give us a renewing of our mind, so that wherever we left off at, we can continue on a better path here on out.
Yeah.
Because we want to be great spiritual fathers and spiritual mothers.
Yeah.
We want to have children that when we're gone, can carry out and maintain the truth of the gospel.
Yeah.
But if we're not training them and trusting them with the message, then what do we have left?
Yes.
Who's going to be the next generation that is going to stand firm on the gospel message?
Yeah.
I mean, yeah, God's going to supernaturally do his work, but he's going to use us as what? That third party.
Boy, yeah.
It's kind of like in the human perspective, he uses the dad to plant the seed, but he's still the creator of life.
Yes.
So he uses us, and we have to accept and take with a privilege the challenge that he has given us.
Yes.
Because at the end of the day, his grace is sufficient for you and for me, just in the same way it was for Paul.
Yes.
I mean, Paul's life wasn't easy if you look at it. But still, and yet, he was faithful to the God that called him to do.
Oh, yeah.
And when we look at Paul, we would all call Paul our spiritual father.
Yes.
And we read through the scripture, who I desire to be like Paul. Not because of who he was particularly, but because of the way he imitated Christ.
Yes.
So that's the way God wants us to be. There's people that are looking up to us or wanting to desire to be like us because right now they can't clearly see the Father, but they can see you.
Yeah.
It's kind of like begin to talk to them, eventually they will see Christ for themselves, but right now you're all they have.
Oh, yes.
So they're trusting and depending on us to make God clear for them.
Yes.
And so we have a responsibility as spiritual fathers.
Oh, yes.
Some of us are still spiritual children. If you're spiritual children, we're not expecting you to have any children. I mean, you know, don't have a child if you're a child. But it's the idea that when you're of age, if you've been walking for 20, 30 years, 15 years, you ought to have some kids by now.
Yeah.
You know, unless you just say, you know what, I'm just content on where I am and what I got going on.
Yes, Lord.
And I'm just going to be selfish about my time, my talents, and my treasures. Amen?
Amen.
And the doors of the church are now open. And you know, as we come, I want to